sitting on a front porch in the early morning breeze. Sitting on a front porch, just an old friend and me. Drink a little coffee, read all the local news, talk a little gossip every now and then. Smell that ham cooking in the kitchen, a brand new sunrise in the sky. Sitting on a front porch, minding all your business, what a way to make the day go by.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, good Monday morning.
I tell you what, I didn't get messed up on my days. I told you I was going to come by and visit with you and Ryan this morning because I was in town and I thought I'd come out and just visit and have a cup of your good coffee. Good morning to you. I'm Terry Mitchell. He didn't tell you who he was, but you know, KD, Kenny Dean.
And Kevin Moon's supposed to be here. I don't know. I don't know. That's all I got to say.
That sounds like a good song. I just don't know,
but I do
like
know
that
this
hat you got on this morning.
Well, we're getting ready for the auction next month, me and
that
Chuck.
That's a good-looking hat, Chuck Bradley. Good morning to you.
Chuck Bradley, it's going to be April the 13th on Highway 9 in Equality, so looking forward to that. And he'll be out here on April Fool's along with George Miranda.
that's a pair that makes a full house.
Brother James Cullins, a good old big morning to you, sir.
Yes, sir. Good morning to all of you on the front porch, and it's a thrill to be back with you this week.
It's always a thrill for you to be with us, and we thank you for taking your time, number one. Well, we appreciate your friendship, and we appreciate the thought for the day. So with that, we'll turn it over to you right now.
Okay, thank you very much. Psalms 37 and verse 37. Says to mark the upright man and follow after him, for the end of his way is peace. And so this week, I want to do that with following a man that I think is upright as much as most anyone that I could think of in the Bible. And so we'll mark him. I don't know if you ever thought about this or not, but Moses met everyone of the qualifications that Jesus gave in the Beatitudes in Matthew chapter 5. Moses truly was an upright man. So this week, our emphasis is going to be on Moses and the follow after him. First thing I want to take up with Moses is he was a meek man. Now the Bible says in Numbers 12 and verse 3, that of all the men on the earth, Moses was the most meek of them all. And when we think of meek, sometimes we think of weakness. But truly, Moses was not a weak man. When he saw Hebrews being mistreated, he took up for them, even to the extent of killing one of his own adopted race, one of the Egyptians. When he went to Midian, and the shepherds came and were harassing the women at the well there, even though Moses was a foreigner. And I just can imagine those shepherds were tough people. But Moses was able to chase them off. And so he was definitely not a weak man. So what do we have when we think of the word meek? Jesus said, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. The best definition that I believe I've ever heard of meekness is to be involved in something that is greater than you are and respect it greater than you do yourself. For instance, David, when Goliath was threatening the armies of Israel, David said, even though he's a young shepherd boy, no battle experience, he said, is there not a cause? Is there not something greater? than this man here. And David forgot himself, and we know the victory that he had with his sling and with the rock against Goliath. So Moses was a man that was involved with things that was greater than he was. He forgot himself. He went all out for the Lord. And the Bible says he was the meekest of men, but not weak. By no means. Anyone that would run those shepherds off, I don't see how he did it. In a foreign country, they could go get their friends. There was a number of them. I don't know how many there were. But Moses chased them off from bothering those women at the well. And of course, from that, he got his wife. And so Moses is a man that we can follow his example. He truly was a meek man, but he's an upright man, and one that if we follow him, we're going to find peace. So number one, this week, let's get involved in something greater than ourselves. And of course, that is the Lord Jesus Christ. By far, he is greater than anything else there is in this world. I love the book of Hebrews. It's a unique book. We don't know who wrote it. We don't know who it's addressed to. But its emphasis is on whatever you can think, whatever we know, Jesus is greater than that. He's greater than angels. He's greater than Melchizedek. He's greater than the priesthood they've had. Jesus is greater. So this is a cause that is greater than we ourselves. And the more we get involved with Jesus, the less we're concerned about ourselves. One of the great problems all of us have is wanting our rights, wanting what's ours, rather than what's best. But Moses was a man that had a cause, and he dedicated himself to that cause. So this week, we're going to mark that upright man, Moses, and today, Moses the meek. Tomorrow we'll take up another characteristic of his that, like I said, he feels every one of the Beatitudes in Moses' life. So we need to mark those for a blessing for ourselves. So I pray today that God will bless all on the front porch, all who listen to us, and that Jesus will be our cause that's far greater than ourselves. Help us, Lord, to do this. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. That's pretty good cause right there, wow, my friend. Pretty good cause, and a great way to start the week off, too.
All right, Kenny. Thank you, and you and Terry have a good week, and all of you at work there at the front porch, and I look forward to being with you tomorrow, and we'll take up another characteristic in the life of Moses.
Looking forward to it. One of my heroes. Thank you, and have a great day, too.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Bye. Brother James Cullen's getting our day started.
I love his wisdom.
We got a lot going on today that I don't even. This is going to be.
Hey, the moon man is in the studio. I saw him.
Well, this is what he said.
No, I just saw him.
I know. I saw him.
You kind of shunned him then.
I'm only a mile from there. I got this a few minutes ago. Got there early. Went to get a biscuit and can't get back. I'll be there in a second. What do you mean can't get back?
I don't know. You can ask him when he shows. He's in the studio.
Can't get back. And it's something like LOL, L-O-L, LOL. Hey, let's talk about the weather right
loud
now. 49 right now. But today is only going to be 59. Now this afternoon, that's going to be even chillier because it's going to be windy. Tonight, freezing. So I know a lot of folks already got those plants out, Terry.
Miss Diane done said I had to get home early to cover them.
29 and clear. Let's look at tomorrow. 59 and 35. I'm getting more wood tomorrow.
You'll need it.
71 and 45. Thursday, 70 and 50. Friday, 62 and 46, about a 60% chance of rain.
Oh, I like that.
Trail
Saturday
riding
forecast
is going to be a good one on Saturday. No rain, 71 and 46. Here's your 5-day forecast brought to you by Alex City Marine. They're located on Cherokee Road right here in Alexander City. Go see them today. Salvation Army.
Well, where are you going to find Salvation Army then?
You know, Salvation Army's on at 6800 US 280 here in Alexander City. A lot of folks are spring breaking it this week. I know they're different times during this month, but this week they're spring breaking it. Excellent time to get your give your children something to do. Clean out their closets. Clean what they're not wearing, the shoes, the pants, the shirts, because somebody needs them. Salvation Army needs them. Take them today.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Gorey at Gorey's Furniture. Come join us for the madness of March. Come join us here at Gorey's Furniture. Make a purchase. Shoot from the line. 5, 10 to 15. That's percent discount off your total ticket. So come join us. Let's have fun. Everyone's a winner. Everyone will save. Come join us for the madness of March. And that's only at Gorey's Furniture.
At Russell Medical, we're proud of our exceptional nurses, like Nurse Brandy Worthy. Brandy represents the selfless, compassionate clinical leader patients expect and coworkers admire. Brandy was recently honored with the Nightingale Award for Nursing Excellence for her high standards, sound judgment, and caring manner. Her passion for her profession inspires us all.
Being a nurse is not just what you do, it's who you are. I'm proud to be a part of the nursing team at Russell Medical. We are the link between all hospital services, providing you with exceptional, personalized care.
In today's challenging world, our children need every advantage found in their education and spiritual formation. If you're looking for a school for your child or your grandchild where they will receive a great education, be in a small class, a safe place, a school where they're prayed for and with, a school where the Bible is integrated into the lessons, a school where they are encouraged and challenged not only in scholastics but also the Christian life, Veritas Lake Martin Christian School may be the place for you. Registration for the next school year has already begun with limited spaces. Call us at 256-537-5004.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
Serving East Central Alabama since 2005, we are Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical of Sylacauga. Coosa Valley Respiratory has medical equipment and supplies, including oxygen to home ventilation services. We carry a full line of bracing, power chairs, scooters, and more. And when you trust Coosa Valley Respiratory, you are dealing with local people that care about your well-being. Providing quality home care for our community, Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical, 201 West Fort William, Sylacauga. Give us a call at 256-245-1411.
The Alex City Parks and Rec Department serves the residents of Alexander City with quality facilities and programs designed to positively affect the lives of the citizens. From youth sports programs to adult activities and our senior center, the Alex City Parks and Rec offers services for all ages. The Cooper Rec Center, Lake Winds Golf Course, and the Senior Activity Center are just some of the great features the Alex City Parks and Rec Department provides for the people of Alex City. For more information on any of our programs, call 256-329-6736.
I thought the season of leprechauns was over yesterday, but I don't guess. Yes, it is. Not Elliot Moon, Kevin Moon out here with us today. And I got to tell you right off the bat, see, he came out here, and he Paul Terry was sitting there, knocked Terry down. Terry messed his hair up, so Terry is going to get his hair fixed.
I said, Terry, get. Go.
How did that call you?
I'm good. How are you?
Found him a cleanest dirty cup he could find in the kitchen in there.
What do y'all do around here?
Nothing.
Good Lord, I had to wash my own cup. I like to have a real coffee cup in the morning. I don't even eat off a paper plate.
You know what?
At Thanksgiving,
mm-hmm.
when everybody's, you know, got plates mm-hmm. and stuff like that and fixing their plate towels, mm-hmm. I try to make the annual speech. Look, I don't feel like I'm better than you. I don't care if I come to your house for Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm.
You want a real plate?
I don't want something is gonna break, yeah. way down and break.
Well, you
or
ain't
anything.
Got to, you ain't got to and then triple pile
and,
it
and,
on.
And then you got that flimsy plastic fork and spoon and.
You know what? I'm gonna agree with you on that because I'm the same way. It's just most time it's just Ellen and I at the house, so we wash.
Ain't got
dishes,
a whole bunch of dishes. Just and, rinse it out.
But now every now and then I'll get that little old real flimsy little old. A paper plate and put a sandwich on it.
Then yeah, no. I because then if I fix a sandwich, I'm probably gonna put chips on there. I put chips on there, and then it's just gonna, it's not gonna be the same. Now look, one thing I can do, I can use a paper plate sometimes if it's on a regular plate. Like, okay, we're not gonna mess the plate up. We're not gonna get it dirty, mm-hmm. so we're gonna put this one on top of this mm-hmm. one and just use it as, you know.
What would David Law do?
I ask myself that on most decisions that I make these days.
Judge David Law, good morning.
Good morning,
good morning
to you, Judge.
To you. How the heck are you?
I've been good. I, you know, sitting here close to 40.
Mm-hmm.
Got a newborn.
Yep.
And I sleep great. And Angela gets up and does all hard stuff. So life ain't bad.
So you just go get biscuits and get lost. He is our guest for today. But Terry did.
For those of you that want to leave now.
What are you? Tell me.
Don't ask me what I'm doing because I don't know.
Well, I know. I got to find out. Well, what are you doing? Have you been doing?
I
got to get cut up with Kevin Moon because he and I kind of lost contact. I'll be honest. We kind of lost contact. I know you've been busy. Or not busy the last couple of years, and
yeah,
I haven't been busy.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
I'm consistent by not being busy.
Oh yeah, I get it. I go to the mailbox, get a check,
mm-hmm.
and you know, get some royalty money off of playing a little music. You know, every time you go to that little Apple Music deal and click that icon and go play a Kevin Moon song, they'll send me fractions on a penny.
Well, tell
I'll
me,
get a check.
Tell me what you are doing in the music world.
Hey, look, we've got something coming up. Yeah, we do. And you know, we've been a part of this thing for a long time. And which you know this, the Keith Whitley Memorial Concert.
It's in the summer.
That's right, coming up June the 29th. And you remember?
The hottest day of the year.
It's always a situation where it's during the middle of the, you know, like a Thursday
mm-hmm.
in the middle of the week. And this year is the very first year that this thing is being done on a Saturday.
Really?
So I'm excited about it. There's going to be I know they got a long list of artists that are going to be part of it, and I'm fortunate enough to get to be part of it again this year. And I love doing it because it's a big weekend. It's, of course, made enough noise, got enough momentum going for mm-hmm. Keith Whitley after him – passing away in 1989 to get him into the Country Music Hall of Fame.
35 years
Yeah,
ago.
You're talking about a man that would
wow.
be, 68?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think folks realize his widow, which would have been, is Lori Morgan.
One of the greatest folks in the whole entire world. I love her to death. Well, it's kind of like me and you. It don't matter how long we go
mm-hmm.
without talking.
Mm-hmm.
We're not going to get off phone without, you know, hey, I love you. You let me know if you need me or whatever the case may be. And having that kind of relationship with somebody like that, not only is it a great relationship and a friendship to have in the business, but you talk about somebody that somebody that knows that business in and out and can give you true guidance and leadership. I got offered a job to go to work, and I won't name the artist, but
seemed like a really good opportunity at the time. Mm-hmm. And got an opportunity to go to work for them on the road and do some road management stuff. And the pay was solid. When you're doing over 100 dates a year, mm-hmm. you know, you're going to be gone quite a bit. But there's compensation in that, too. But I called her and I said, hey, look, I used you as a reference. I hope you don't mind. She said, you use me as a reference anytime you want to. She said, but now since you referenced me, I'm going to tell you what I think about that situation.
That's what here comes the friend
and,
part.
Well, she said, since, you used me as a reference there, I'm gonna be a reference for them. Mm-hmm. And she told me what she thought about that. Not that job in particular, as far as, you don't want to do that for a living, but you don't want to do it for that particular person. And she let me know, and soon after that, I found out why. So, having folks like that to look after you. I don't know what I want to be when I grow up. Mm-hmm. I'm still trying to figure that out.
You know, and I've not been around Lori as much as you have, but when I was with dealing with Bobby Randall and up there a good bit, and I remember, and you talking about a girl that she's just as sweet as she can be, but you talking about somebody that tell it just like it is. I thought about her this weekend, Jack Green.
She ain't good.
would have been still been living. Then went to Jack Green. It was a fundraiser in Nashville for her bass player.
I love this story right here.
He wound up, he had cancer. He was still playing, and he's since passed with cancer. But Jack Green was one of the artists that went out there and sang. And I'm just hanging around backstage, and when Jack Green came up, and he just sang his rear end off.
Look, all the way up until the end, he was still hitting that high note on Statue of a Fool.
That's exactly.
And absolutely killing it.
But when he came off and they're helping him get off the stage and helping him.
You gonna use the censored version?
And Lori Morgan, and I will not quote what Lori Morgan said, but she said
in the kindest way,
he can sing his rear end off, but the SOB don't know where he is.
He might not have an
idea
where he is.
But he
could flat out bring the thunder. He could haul the mail.
Yeah. But, and she has dealt with so many. Of course, her dad, George Morgan.
She's been around
Candy Kisses.
So
I mean, she'd been around the Opry all her life.
Well, she was a member before she ever even had a hit.
Wow. Didn't realize that.
She was a member of the Opry before she even had a hit. Going back to, I don't know what year she became a member, but, she was on the road with the George Jones mm-hmm. boys. Mm-hmm. Jones boys, yeah. And she was on the road with them during the Ron Gaddis days when Ron was singing, harmony and playing mm-hmm. bass with George. Mm-hmm. And that was her first husband, Ron Gaddis. And
I didn't know
sure
that.
Sure was, yeah.
And, I know she'd been married about.
She don't mind talking about that either. She don't mind talking about that
either. She's married to Randy White now.
Randy is such a great guy. And I'm going to tell you this, another thing. Someone that has not only just supported her in the industry, but also someone that, it can be tough to be in. And we'll just say maybe in the shadow or whatever of Keith Whitley mm-hmm. to somebody that a lot of people associate Lori with Keith, and she's still so involved with his name, his legacy, that big introduction in the Hall of Fame, and Randy is as much of a Keith Whitley fan as anybody else, and is right there by her side. And I'll never forget, we were all out there. This was the big Whitley show. It was pre-COVID. But we were all out at the hotel, and out at the hotel parking lot there was a big screen that was set up, a very big projector screen, and they played live right there. I'm sorry. Thank you for doing these mics like this, by the way, Ryan. on the projector screen there, there's Keith Whitley live from Austin City Limits. Mm-hmm. And a crazy thing, because it feels like a concert. Mm-hmm. Everybody there. I mean, after every song, there's people clapping, and there's hundreds of people that are out there on this kind of grassy green area, mm-hmm. just with their blankets and their drinks, and they're watching this concert live from 1989, just months before the guy passes away. And it was like he was still alive, and her and Randy are sitting right there kind of down front and center, and he's got his arm around her, yeah. And they're watching it, and she's, you know, obviously talking, telling stories, this, that, and the other. But it was just a great thing.
Yeah, that's what I've always admired about him. He is a big-time supporter of her. Of course, Keith Whitley died tragically of an alcohol overdose.
I mean, that's correct.
You know, he just couldn't, you know, he'd go on these benches, and, you know, I've even heard she'd chain him to the...
She would tie her leg to his.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And another thing that was interesting to me was just the fact that nobody, and she's told this to me so many times, nobody ever saw Keith drink.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He was just a closet drinker.
Mm-hmm.
And,
but when he did.
Well, now RCA put him on a plane, and they sent him to a rehab.
Oh, really?
Facility to dry him out.
Mm-hmm.
And and Jack McFadden said, "This is your last straw. Mm-hmm. This is it. You blow it this time, you're off the label." And he goes. He spends all that time at that rehab, and they pick him up at the airport. He's drunk when he got off the plane.
Addiction.
It's tough.
We'll be right back. This is just one of the things that's Wind Creek State Park that Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County Tourism promotes, and that's the zip line there. Now, they have a whole lot more, and it'd be a lot of folks down there, especially with spring break this week. Weather's going to be pretty nice this week. So, Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County Tourism, thank you for promoting
sure.
Our area. We appreciate it.
Floyd's Feed and Seed covers both sides of the road in downtown Dable. Incredible selection of plants, stones, insecticides, and gift selection in the additional part. Original store has tack and boots for men, women, and children, gloves, hats, belts, and Carhartt clothing. Come on in and visit. Open Monday through Saturday for your convenience with a whole lot of service. Floyd's Feed and Seed, downtown Dable, Alabama.
We are Debt Relief Agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
This is Marcia Mason, your local Lake Martin Bankruptcy and Social Security Disability Attorney. Mason Law Firm is located at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Call 256-329-1313 to schedule your appointment today. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Trust Dixie Overhead Door to restore your garage door with a comprehensive tune-up. For a limited time, it's free for Dixie Cares Plan members and only $49.99 for others. Avoid a real-life nightmare and take care of the most important door in your home. Regular maintenance can reduce noises and potential breakdowns, extend the life of your opener, door, tracks, and springs, and quickly spruce up the space, especially important if it's turned into your new man cave.
Central Alabama. This is our home. It's where we work, where we play, where we raise our families and grow old. And in the unfortunate event we become sick with cancer, thanks to UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center, this is where we heal also. We have invested in new technologies and expertise so that now we're able to treat all sorts of cancers and you never have to leave Tallapoosa County. UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center. Compassionate, convenient, collaborative cancer care right here at home.
It's that time of the year again for the second annual Bradley Equipment Auction, April the 13th, starts at 8:30. Now, you can go down there anytime beforehand and start checking out the trailers, the tractors, the trucks, all the equipment that's going to be on site. Live on site bidding will be going on the day of, live internet bidding now. Get in touch with them today at 256-786-2763.
Farmers and Merchants Bank of Dadeville is building a foundation of strength and trust in the entire Lake Martin community. With our modern branch in Dadeville and caring, attentive staff, we've established Farmers and Merchants Bank as a reliable friend to your banking needs. Whether it's just a savings or checking account or any commercial, auto, or real estate loan, Farmers has local decision-making to build a relationship with you and your needs. Farmers and Merchants Community Bank. Strength. Service. Community. You don't have to ask who, what, or why. Who's Diner is the go-to place for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Conveniently located at the corner of Highway 22 and 280 in Alex City, Who's Diner offers the best meals and the best deals in town. Try our fresh, made-from-scratch pancakes, chicken salad, Philly cheesesteak, or the Who Burger. It doesn't get any better than Who? Who's Diner, of course, on the corner of Highway 22 and 280. Who's hungry?
Come back in here, George. Hey, let me remind you that Lake Martin Garden Shop on Highway 63. If you're leaving Alex City, it's gonna be right past the Wind Creek State Park. If you're coming this way, it's gonna you know where it is. There it is, right there, where good things grow. They got the ferns and tropicals will be here Thursday. They got the hanging baskets in the flower, all the little flower type flowers in now. Flower pots of all sizes. They're open Monday through Saturday, 9 to 4, and Sunday, 1 to 4. I'm talking about Lake Martin Garden Shop. Come back in here and join us right now with Kevin Moon. Out here, we got all kind of stories. Because Kevin and I go way back to the radio days up in Clay County.
Even prior to that, but certainly working together and having the opportunity to do that.
What did we do prior to that?
I don't remember
anything.
Well, we just...
Where did we meet?
On the set here. Me and Wayne Hubbard came in. I sang He Stopped Loving Her Today on the show one morning. I wore this real ugly green shirt with a yellow undershirt, and I had these real stupid-looking Eddie Bauer glasses on. Not a single hair out of place.
The years, how they can change. You know, I was looking at some Barnyard Jamboree yesterday. I don't know how I found some videos, and the Roys, they're brother and sister, yeah. Bluegrass, Elaine and Lee. Lee drives for one of the real big. He drives a bus for him, but their harmony is just unreal.
And when you're able to spend that much time with folks, you know, your wife or your siblings, and you grow up around one another, each other, you can practice some harmonies and get them.
They were from Massachusetts, and they came down, and they still are involved. They're not together anymore. Kurt Webster was their manager, I guess, mm-hmm. at the time, and had them going all over the place.
Kurt's a very involved publicist.
Yeah,
he's very, very active, and he's. He's another guy that's been a good guy to just be able to call on if I needed something.
Kurt had every big name in the world with him, and then he had some issues, and a lot of those pulled out and left him. But so he's regained. But he's
introduced me to a lot of folks.
Yeah. He knows a lot of folks. That's his life.
I got
that's
to drink wine and eat cheesecake with. Paula Deen, because of him. Yeah, we had a great time.
Where was that? Is that in Nashville?
That was in Huntsville.
In Huntsville.
It was at the big Lee Greenwood concert they did of Lee and his, I think, 40 or 50, whatever many years he'd been in the industry. But
I bet it's been 50 years.
There's that. And then, of course, that big – look, here, you talk about disappointment.
Mm-hmm.
So Kurt's real good friends. He was great friends with George Jones and great friends with Miss Nancy. And I got an invitation to come to Nancy's house one night for a very private dinner. Just, you know, a handful of folks going to be there. But just, you know, she had a brand new book that just came out a few months ago called Playing. I think it's called Still Playing Possum.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And she talks a lot about, obviously, her marriage to George and, you know, the good, the bad, the ugly, and all mm-hmm. that stuff. And, but I got my days mixed up on my calendar and flat out forgot about it and missed that opportunity. But Kurt's another one of those guys that is just a you know, if I got a question, shoot him a text, give him a phone call, yeah. and he's going to shoot it to me straight, whether I like it
good
or don't like it.
That's what you want.
And he ain't going to paint it pretty if it ain't pretty. And that's the kind of friends you want.
Let's go to Tootsie's right now in on Broadway in Nashville. You ready?
Yeah.
Have you ever played there?
Oh, Lord, yeah.
I know
yeah.
you have in Panama City.
Played Panama City, played there at Tootsie's, which is also they own the Honky Tonk Central there just down the strip.
Didn't know that.
And John and them guys over there have been great to me, played and had some good times before it was a three-story bar. Now I don't really know my way around Broadway. I had some friends of mine that wanted to go from Seattle back, you know, I don't know, a handful of years ago, 4, 5, 6 years ago, however long it's been. And they said, let's go down to Broadway and show us around. I'm all excited about it. I go down there. I don't know where darn thing is. I mean, literally, I said, well, you know, something used to be here.
Tootsie's opened this month in 1960. We got a few pictures of that some of the folks that had been there. It was called, it was Mom's start with, was the original name of Tootsie's Orchid Lounge. Then Tootsie Bess, and I thought about, she's the one that had it, but I thought about Lou Bess at Colonel Tom's. Well, there's Willie and Chris Christopherson. That's way back in. Now, it's a honky-tonk. It's just a nasty old honky-tonk. But you know what? That's and it reminded me of the old Colonel Tom's in its own way. But Willie, him and Trigger, his guitar that's he's known for. But this is, you got to look, this is several years ago. That's even got it in color there also. But it was Charlie Pride gave her the jeweled hat pin that she used to stick unruly patrons with. It's rumored that Roger Miller wrote Dang Me in Tootsie's. One of my favorite songwriters, Roger Miller. Famous early customers, Chris.
I tell this story sometimes because I think it's a wonderful story. And I think it just expresses how much out of the box Roger Miller thought. Just so far left of center.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But he was riding down the road in Texas with Willie, and Willie was driving. Roger was in the back. Willie thinks Roger's sleeping or whatever. Says it's either the most beautiful sunrise or sunset. I don't remember. I think it was a sunrise, though. And you know how those cars were built back in the 60s, you know, and you lean up and put your arm on that bench seat and just mm-hmm. kind of prop up. Roger says, Willie, can you imagine what God could have done if he had had money? And, you know, it's humorous to think about, but to think so deep that God could make such a masterpiece on no mm-hmm. budget whatsoever, mm-hmm. can you imagine what God could have done if he had had money? Who thinks like that?
Roger Miller.
It's brilliant. He was absolutely genius. And I think there's a certain amount of crazy that goes with being a genius. And I think that all those guys were crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely crazy. And I sent Ryan some pictures of one of the times that we played, that we were playing at Tootsie's.
Oh, really? I didn't know that. I was just looking this weekend because I knew it was coming up 64 years. Of course, also,
which I texted him to him, so I don't know if he, yeah.
Also,
look at there.
Wow. That's right in front. Who are some of these guys?
All right, now I'm going to go to the guy in the American flag top hat there. I don't know what kind of shirt George is wearing. Pedal steel. Alan Preston there on the bass. And then, of course, for those of you that are tuned in on radio, you can't see this, but a picture of me and all the guys out front of Tootsie's Orchid Lounge there. Me in the middle there. Randy Stewart on the fiddle. And Jason Cole on lead guitar there. And Ken Harper was playing drums with us at the time. And there she is. World famous
wow.
Tootsie's Orchid Lounge.
We had a first time
great crowd. That was the either the I think that picture was from the first time, first
one,
or second time.
One of my favorite, of course, WW that Calvin Fitzgerald Whaley, that's Maggie Nick's son. I called WW. One of the Tootsie, one of the movies filmed at Tootsie's was named after WW and the Dixie Dance King, starring Burt Reynolds. Coal Miner's Daughter had a part in there, and several others. A segment of the Dean Martin Show was even put in there. Willie Nelson got his first songwriting job out of there. Tootsie was known to slip $5 and $10 into the pockets of luckless writers and pickers. And don't you know there was a bunch of them that came through there, and she found a bunch of IOUs after she closed up too. But historic place. But you're right. It's not Nashville that
it's not the honky tonk that it once was.
No,
and I'm not knocking it because it is. It's what that's become. But I've been watching this series on one of those streaming platforms. I don't know. Where the Friends in Low Places bar and grill is going up on, I think on Printer's Alley is where it's going up at. But they are not sparing any expense. Garth is going about this thing. Garth and Trisha are going about this thing the right way.
Mm-hmm.
The stage that they're using in that honky-tonk there it's retractable, but the stage that they use for, you know, when you stand on the stage at the opera, you stand in the circle.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Garth said, obviously, this wasn't to that magnitude, but he wanted the people to know when they played there, he actually found a piece of the stage from the production company that did the big, huge, you remember that show he did live at Central Park?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Found a piece of that stage.
Really?
And you know the little G logo? So when you step into the G, then you step right there, and there's a piece of that stage, and it changes colors because it was a metallic kind of, I don't know, like a diamond plate-looking deal, but you can see through it, different color light, stuff like
that. Garth is still around. We'll be right back. Let me tell you about Lake Martin Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce, what they have going on. Well, a whole lot going on, but the Funky Goat will be the place for the after-hours meet and greet. That's going to be Thursday, May 28th, a week from this Thursday, from 5 to 6:30. Just come on out. It'd be a great way to meet folks. It'd be a great way to maybe become a chamber member of the Lake Martin Dadeville Area Chamber of Commerce.
King Honda Car World kicks off 2024 with an unbeatable selection of new Hondas, available now for immediate delivery. Experience great products, an incredible selection, and fantastic prices on all of our new Honda inventory in stock. Our goal this month is to make it a month to remember by offering year-end deals at the start of the year. That way you get the best savings on any Honda in stock. Need to trade in your car? We're offering top dollar for quality trades, making your deal even better. Plus, this month only, enjoy free leather upgrades on all Honda Accord EX models. And we've got plenty in stock. Thank you for making 2023 our best year ever, and we're excited for an even better 2024.
Thank you all for a great 2023. I welcome the opportunity to meet you in person at our Honda store, where I know our staff will take great care of you. We hope to see you soon.
Visit our new facility at 2332 U.S. Highway 280 and start enjoying your new 2024 Honda this year.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
As your State Farm team, we will be there for you with the financial strength to deliver on our promises. Service that's a sure thing. You can think of us as your good neighbors who help protect what's important to you. We're here when you need us the most. You can call us 24/7 to get answers to your questions, file a claim, or see if we can find you more ways to save. We have many coverages and many discounts. We can help protect more areas of your life and find every discount you qualify for along the way. Please call us or visit 2048 Cherokee Road for coverage you can count on.
Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, is looking for the next hometown hero. Hometown heroes could be first responders, public service workers, community leaders, pastors, community volunteers, or anyone who is making a difference in your hometown. Submit your nominations now online at myhscu.com. And if your nominee is selected, they will get a $100 Visa cash card and a certificate of appreciation from Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union. Federally insured by the NCUA.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with the service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
Come on back in here, and we're going to go back about 20 years right now, and in this same control room that Ryan Fuller is sitting, Pam Buttram from Richville, good morning, Pam and Butch, she was producing, and see this little tiny basket, that's her grandson, Brantley, and his mom, Tabitha, was just out here last week. Now, 20 years ago, little Brantley was in there with his grandmama, but now he's in the Air Force. And here in a couple of months, that little boy in that little basket is fixing to go to Korea with the Air Force. So, son, we salute you. Just had to show that. A friend of mine became the Woman of the Year, and I, very deserving, Ann Gorey, that she was presented this Lead Forward Women's Conference, which is just Chamber of Commerce, classy Woman of the Year. Of course, there's her family in the background, and this is one of the coolest pictures of her husband, Tom, with the flowers. But Ann has done so much behind the scenes. Of course, I grew up with Ann Gorey from the first grade on. But Ann was a teacher for almost 50 years, sweetest person you'll ever run into, but she's that type person that does so much behind the scene and doesn't want any recognition. So I'm very glad Mary Perry there was the Woman of the Year last year presenting her. So to Ann Gorey and to her family, congratulations. Kevin Moon with us out here, and he's brought a what's all the caps over there for? You getting rid of your caps?
No, Lord, no. I got a big old cap collection, and I was piddling around over here saying hey to some folks, so. Billy Jack's got us tuned in this morning. My brother Billy Jack tuned in over in Talladega this morning.
Billy Jack. I love. I remember the movie.
Love you, brother.
I know in the movie Billy Jack. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I do.
He, of course, Billy Jack was a tough guy. Tom Laughlin, I believe, was his name.
Billy Jack used to beat the mess out of me.
Well, this Billy Jack would too. He's sitting there talking to this guy, and he said, "Hey, I'm going to take my left foot and I'm going to put it on your right ear. And he said, it's not going to be anything you can do about it. And he gave him a good kicking real quick. Now last time I saw Tom Law offering this bit of jack, He would have a hard time picking up that left foot.
You don't
foot.
Think he can do it now?
No, he's a little overweight.
I don't think Billy Jack could do it either. So, but I will
Billy Jack. You got a friend named Billy Jack. I love it.
Well, I got a brother named Billy Jack. But he is my friend. Yeah, he's my friend.
Good morning, my friend.
But he is a great, great guy. I should strive to be more like Billy Jack.
Well, won't you try to do that? Why
well, I said I should. I didn't say I would.
Hey, congratulations to the Auburn Tigers. As they won the SEC tournament, they'll move on to play Yale, I believe.
They're playing Yale. They sure are.
Alabama.
Alabama playing Charleston.
Charleston.
I think there's six or seven SEC teams in the NCAA tournament coming up. So SEC was strong this year. Very strong.
Okay. I don't keep up basketball.
Well, and this is where it gets fun. And Alabama, you know, Nate Oates, they just signed a extension, making him one of the top five highest paid coaches in the country for –
Do you know Bruce Pearl's daughter works for Russell Medical Foundation?
No, I didn't.
Yeah,
no,
Jackie Pearl.
I did not.
Hey, enjoyed the tumbleweeds. We finally had enough to get together this past week. David Mitchell did a great job with the cooking.
How do you get involved in that? How do you become like an honorary member?
We had 12. We are down to about 9 now. We've lost. We lost Blake Schaffer a few years back. Ed Funderburg.
I got blackballed from the Masonic Lodge, so I can just
recently we lost Danny Brown. So we're at that age, and this week we're not getting together because so many got doctor's appointments and that type of things. We get together when we can. But Mitchell had Coon's Corner cater it with poppy seed chicken casserole that was out of this world. Jennifer, our hat goes off to you. That was on Thursday night. Friday night we kept baby girl Genevieve. And WW. And
loving that life or what?
I love it, but I love to visit them. I found that because when we took them back Saturday about noontime, we were whipped. Absolutely whipped. Now, you're going through that same thing right now. You know what I'm talking about. But we're a lot older than you.
It does get to wear on you. And I didn't really think it would be that much different this go around, but it has been different. Things change. You wear out different, and things hurt now that they didn't used to hurt.
Pushing 40 like you are. I know you got a couple of years, but I was 40 when Maggie was born.
And it was different too.
It was different than Kenny Jr.
But I'm gonna tell you, Angela, this is her first child, and the woman is just fantastic. She does a fantastic job with the baby and I don't tell her enough, but she is a wonderful mother, and this is her first go around, and I know that she's been nervous about it, and of course you want to do it right. There's my little Eminem. Yep, studying real hard about that bath time there, but He's a hand user. He keeps some hands right up around his head.
How old is he?
A month.
In his full name?
Emory Thomas Moon.
Emory Thomas Moon.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Love it.
It's a really good family name. There's Miss Waylon Claire. she wanted for Christmas was her two front teeth. And there's the boys are certainly growing, Weston and Wyatt. So. The family is doing their thing. There they are in front of the Troy Jones Memorial Tree there in Sylacauga. And Troy was another great songwriter, gone too soon. And love him.
Love the family pictures.
Thank you. I'm a picture person. I'm a print picture person. Like I will still go to the pharmacy and print off pictures and hang them on the wall and stuff like that, because
Troy,
this becomes a photo album, I think, that we depend on too much.
You bring up Troy Jones. It's funny because yesterday I was here again. I was looking. I don't know how I find stuff sometimes, because I'm not real good at it.
Go down them rabbit trails.
I found three interviews that I did with Troy. This is for a lot of folks knew Troy Jones, and it was at his house.
The one on Lay Lake?
No.
Oh, the one before then.
Yeah, this one before Lay Lake. But Troy Jones was a great a singer-songwriter.
I loved him. We had the opportunity to write a couple of mm-hmm. times, and just to hang out in the studio, and I got to produce a demo on Troy.
On Troy?
Mm-hmm. And so that was fun.
What's the difference? I know what the difference is, but what's the difference in producing and being produced? Is there a big difference?
On the production side, you go in there with somebody that trusts you to help them make the calls mm-hmm. of, because you, as a singer, you want to sing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as an artist and a creator, you enjoy the process of a painter can see things, mm-hmm. or an interior designer can see things mm-hmm. that aren't there.
I see. I don't
okay.
know what you're
talking about. I hear things that aren't there.
Okay, I do too.
Yeah, and sometimes I talk back, and that's the part of being on the production side that I enjoy. You know, hey, let's. You know, I want to hear them big old thick harmonies mm-hmm. right here, or fiddle here, or steel. Absolutely,
here.
Yeah. Just you know, hearing those sig licks and or those signature licks mm-hmm. on a song, mm-hmm. and then you know somebody that trusts you to help produce a project. And I've been fortunate to get to produce some really cool stuff. So
let me ask you this: since we're talking music, and I both love top music, but let me ask you this. If there's a young person or any, you know, it doesn't have to be young, that's wanting to get into this scene right now,
mm-hmm.
music scene, what do you tell them?
We'll talk about it when we come back.
In just a bit. Speaking of Coon's Corner Deli or catering, let's speak of their deli today. Meatloaf, mashed potatoes, mixed greens, butter beans, carrots, green beans, English peas, corn, and cherry cobbler. That's what's going on at Coon's Corner Deli today.
For over 80 years, the staff members of Radney and Langley Funeral Home have been friends in time of need, and we are dedicated to honoring, sharing, and preserving the amazing and inspirational stories of life.
You've got a friend.
And Obituaries are brought to you by our friends at Radney Funeral Home and Langley Funeral Home, and thank goodness we have no obituaries to report today, but I know there's family, there's friends that's lost family members, and our heart goes out to each and every one of you, but to the men and women that are fighting for our freedom, and to our first responders, God bless you. God bless the USA, and we'll be right back.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritons, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Arise is public transportation from downtown Alexander City. Now, from downtown Alexander City, they cover a 20-mile radius. Those vans are all over the place. When's the last time you went to see that friend? When's the last time you really needed to go to the doctor, but you didn't have a ride? Well, now you got one. It's Arise. Remember this. It's public transportation. Their number to call is 256-329-8444.
Have you been to Sure Shot Outdoors lately? Owner Scott Watson invites you to come in and take a peek at everything they have to offer. Not only do they carry the products you need, whether you're a beginner or an experienced shooter, their experienced staff offers both knowledge and the service you deserve. They also carry apparel, grills, coolers, and much more. Come on in and browse Sure Shot Outdoors today, your one-stop shop for all things outdoors. Located on Highway 280 in Alex City.
Grace's Flowers in Alexander City on Hillaby Street has been making people happy for decades. Susie Kelly and her friendly staff continue that same great tradition. Grace's Flowers is a full-service florist for all occasions, funerals, weddings, and other special events. In addition to flowers, Grace's has a great gift selection as well. To send a smile or encouragement, call 234-4238, and Grace's Flowers will deliver. Grace's Flowers on Hillaby Street in Alexander City.
Jeremy Worthy with Worthy Plumbing and Construction is carrying on a great family tradition, proudly serving the Lake Martin area and doing new construction, plumbing repairs, remodels, and a whole lot more. So keep this number handy, 205-936-4705. That's Worthy Plumbing and Construction. Again, the number to call is 205-936-4705. That's Mr. Jeremy Worthy.
Announcing Lake Martin Medical Center's new address at 815 Lee Street. Dr. Basil Rafai offers services in primary care, provides bioidentical hormone pelleting, and specializes in treating leg sores in the Lake Martin and surrounding areas. Our med spa also offers IPLs, laser hair removal, and a variety of aesthetic products and procedures for your skincare needs. We're your one-stop shop to looking and feeling your best. Call 256-212-9300 to schedule your appointment. That's 256-212-9300.
With the new year ringing in, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is ready for your lawn and tractor needs with a great selection of new and used Mahindra tractors and implements or Spartan mowers. And we're not just selling, we're buying. We'll buy your used tractor, car, truck, boat, motorcycle, even if you're not buying from us. And we pay on the spot. Whatever your tractor or mower needs, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is doing business and paying on the spot. Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor, Highway 280 across from Home Depot.
Let's get updated on Lake Martin Garden Shop. Just got this in from Phil Blassingame, the owner. Some discussion topics. My shipment of ferns, tropical plants, and all types of flowers will be delivered this Thursday. I know we mentioned that earlier, but he said we'll be fully stocked with everything fresh from Florida. So this weekend will be the time to come pick out the flowers and shrubs. That's Lake Martin Garden Shop. Elliot, Elliot Moon, good morning to you, buddy, and hope you're doing well. Kevin Moon with us out here this morning. And it's kind of a get-together, kind of a
reunion.
Kind of a family reunion, literally.
It is.
But we're glad you're out here with us. Tomorrow, there'll be another Dean who will start off with me in the morning, Keith Dean. I want to talk about his coon dog and his hunting and all that tomorrow.
So oh, that's fun.
I'm a big fan of my old buddy Keith Dean. Justin Whitehead will be out here tomorrow from the Cattlemen's Association. And from the Tallapoosa County Extension Agency, Jamie Enos will be out here. So there's our lineup for tomorrow.
You got your good group of folks coming in.
Well, you know, we're blessed. You know, we're booked the rest of this month. We're booking April right now. To keep doing this, and of course you've been a part of it over the years. You kind of know how it works on TV and radio. And
Weston's calling. You want to put him on air?
Put him on.
We'll put him on right now.
Hey.
Good morning, son. I'm live on the television this morning with you. You want to talk?
Oh, well, can I call you back in a little bit?
Oh, this is a family.
Well, you want to say hey to Kenny Dean?
Hey.
Hey, buddy. How you doing?
Good.
That's like that wants to be a private conversation.
Yeah, well, you can call me back later this evening, whatever you want to do, okay?
All right. All right. I love you.
Hey, y'all have a good day. I love y'all too, son.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, baby girl.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, baby girl. Best day ever, okay?
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, son.
Later.
All right, I love all y'all.
Love
best day ever. That's how we start our day.
Oh, boy, it just don't get any better than that. So you're still close with all the children.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Starting another life, or not really another life. But
yeah, just, you know, a little bit of a reset button.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's a good place.
Mm-hmm.
It's because, you know, there's a darkness that comes with divorce, but also mm-hmm. When you can appreciate the person that you're divorcing and respect the person that when you two are separated and you truly put your best interests to the side.
Yep.
And make it about those youngins.
Yep.
And let that be the primary focus, because that is the only thing that you two will have to focus on for the next however many years. Forever, really. I mean, as long as those babies are alive.
I just heard it with them.
That's what yeah. It is, you know. And so, you know, I think that the two of us truly have a lot of respect for each other mm-hmm. to make sure that those babies are taken care of the best way possible. And she's taking them to school this morning. And
I'm fixing to ask you how that's working. But like I said, I just heard it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's good. Do you get to see them as much as you can, I guess?
We have a 50-50 joint custody situation.
Okay.
So nobody sees them more than the other.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as our, just say, divorce papers,
yeah.
You know, if I can encourage anybody to do this, I strongly encourage it.
Mm-hmm.
The divorce papers are what we use to fall back on. If we can't figure it out and we can't come to an agreement,
mm-hmm.
then we go to the divorce papers. What do those say?
Yeah.
And we don't have to do that, really.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we don't, because we can figure it out together. We don't need those papers to tell us how to raise our children.
Yeah, yeah, so, you're right.
So that's what we use those papers for. If we cannot figure it out together, then we'll just do what the paper says.
Well, and divorce, like you said, it can be dark. I mean, you know. It can.
And look, and I'll tell you this, too. There are a lot of outside elements that can come into a mm-hmm. divorce. So as long as you put up barriers,
mm-hmm.
and I wasn't very good at that for the longest, and you let a lot of external factors influence the way that you feel, the way that you act and react because of things that people say and things that people, you know, say about you. Mm-hmm. And so I just encourage folks to, for one thing, stay out of other folks' business. Other things,
I'm with you.
Just, you know, mind your own and take care of yourself and take care of the kids and let the papers be the deciding factor if you can't figure it out.
I was thinking about you yesterday. In fact, I even talked to Ellen about it a little bit. You know, when I walked out on the front porch many years ago,
mm-hmm.
and when I worked up in Clay County, people know how I felt about that. With nothing against Kevin Moon, awkward, you and I became
friends.
Oh,
I didn't do anything but make us better.
But you know, it was a dark, if I've ever had a dark part, that was my dark part. I remember sitting around.
I
wasn't a talkative person then.
Remember.
I was drinking a whole lot more.
I remember.
And not enjoying it.
Going through that.
Yeah, but I remember just being in my den and just trying to figure out what was going on, because life had been good, and then all of a sudden life wasn't good. But you've heard me say this:
humbling.
It was the best worst year of my life,
and a very humbling experience.
Ooh, but I needed that. I needed to be knocked down, and I thank the man upstairs every day for doing that.
Right.
At the time, did I understand it? No. But I tell you what I tried to do. So if you're going through some dark times now, try this. If you think you've got it bad, look around, and you don't have it so bad.
And just realize that most of the time, when people are posting something on social media, or people are talking about their lives, they're talking about the good. They're spotlighting the positive things.
That's what I'm gonna do.
Well, and that's fine. That's great. Mm-hmm. You know, nobody wants to hear a bunch of dreary sadness. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, that doesn't mean they're not going through personal tough things too. So you're not the only one dealing with stuff, and everybody's dealing with their own battles, their own demons, and you know, on the outside looking in, we may think we got it all figured out about somebody, but until you actually go through some of those things and go through some of those places, you don't have a clue. And you talk about a truism.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You find out who your friends are.
Yeah.
You've got nothing to offer anybody.
Yeah.
But your friendship.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you'll find out a lot about a lot of folks.
Yeah.
So one of the things that I can take out of the last couple of years is to try and be a better friend to people.
Mm-hmm. Well, people heard me talk about this just recently, because when my buddy Danny Brown passed, all of a sudden I realized what a friendship really is, what it was. And then I think about Wilma Dean. You've heard me. I know I'm saying this. I just got through saying this a while back. But I remember him telling me, if you can count all your friends on one hand, you're doing good. And I've never bought that, because over the years I'm thinking, oh, man, you don't know what you're talking about. Now that hand,
it means a lot.
It means a lot.
Hey, look, when we come back, we're going to talk about country music advice that we didn't talk about.
Oh, that's right. I'd forgotten. We'll be right back. Forbes Auto Sales Highway 280 in Kellyton, Alabama. I should have asked old Terry Mitchell what was going on up there. I tell you what, I'm only about a couple hundred miles away, not from Forbes Auto Sales, but getting my truck service at 40,000. It's about to turn finally 40,000 miles, and I've had it for 3 years now. Forbes Auto Sales, where I'm going to get it done. You can too.
OGS Tournaments presents Crank for Bank. Win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. Over 200 tag bass and 75 tag crappie are waiting to be caught by you in Lake Martin. Register now online at crankforbank.com for only $120. All ages are welcome. Fish from the dock, boat, or the shores of Lake Martin to win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. It's Crank for Bank.
For years, Tom Watley's been a name you can trust to represent you. And now you can depend on Tom Watley Law, LLC to handle all of your legal needs. Tom has over 20 years of practicing criminal defense, probate needs, and estate planning. Tom Watley Law supports the communities of Lee and Tallapoosa County and can handle all your legal needs or refer you to their network of specialty attorneys. When it counts, call Tom Watley Law, LLC at 334-559-3420 or online at tomwatleylaw.org. No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Hillaby Towers is an affordable senior citizens community located in Alexander City on Highway 22 East. Spacious one bedrooms are available now. Great location, peaceful setting, comfortable living where pets are allowed and utilities are included. Call today to find out more information on Alexander City's best kept secret, 256-329-0552. That's Hillaby Towers in Alexander City.
Medicare for Veterans, MedicareSalute.com. Medicare for Veterans, helping to maximize your VA, CHAMP VA, and TRICARE benefits. Call 256-675-5315 today. Ask for Amber Walker. Ask about Medicare, life, health, dental, and final expenses. Do that today. Call 256-675-5315.
Inspired by the bold bison, Southern Union students blaze new trails every single day. They press forward knowing their SU education will lead them to success. Affordable, accessible, and locally unparalleled. Whether you're transitioning to a university or launching straight into a lucrative career, a degree from SUSCC can help you blaze your path. Three locations, dedicated faculty and staff, endless possibilities. It's all waiting for you at Southern Union. It's time to venture forward. Register today.
If you haven't been to Big B Barbecue in Alex City, then you're missing the best barbecue around. Big B has everything from the best pulled or chopped pork, chicken, and beef to cheeseburgers and grilled chicken salads. Bring your friends and family out for a great dinner and sit outside on our beautiful patio. Or sit inside and enjoy your meal by the fireplace. So come in and join us and enjoy the best barbecue in the area only at Big B Barbecue, located on Highway 22 West in Alex City.
$500 over invoice now at Tony Sarah Ford. Every new Ford on the lot, $500 over invoice when you trade and finance with Tony Sarah Ford. Plus 3.9% financing for 72 months. Save thousands on new F-150s and more. All backed by Sarah's lifetime warranty. No charge. Every new Ford, $500 over invoice at Tony Sarah Ford. In Sylacauga, TonySarahFord.com.
Seven right now, going up to 59. Now this afternoon, it's going to be a pretty chilly 59 because it's going to be real windy. Tonight, 29 and clear. We got us a freeze warning going on. Tomorrow, 59 and 35 and sunny, 71 and 45 on Wednesday, 70 and 50 on Thursday, Friday, a little rain, 62 and 46. Saturday will be a good one. Trail ride good one, 71 and 46. No rain. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by
Job Good Pest Control, Highway 280 in Alexander City.
Jim Hardy, good morning. Jerome Messer, good morning. Betty Robinson, good morning. David Law, good morning. And the question of the day, before we get back to that question about country music, getting into it right now, from Andy Tucker. Did Paula Deen use paper plate? Those Chinette paper plates. Also, let you answer when I come back. Music Depot opens 10 to 5 Monday through Wednesday, 9 to 5 on Thursday, and 8 to 12 on Saturday. So there's some new times for
If I come Music by there Depot. To buy a guitar today, will he cut me a good deal?
Out the door price, that's what he'll – yeah, heck yeah, he'll cut you a deal. That's Andy Tucker. He's a deal-cutting – guy.
Yeah.
Did Paula Deen use Chinette plates?
We used real everything.
Real?
It was all catered in.
Okay. So yeah. She didn't even do the cooking?
It was her recipe.
Okay. And her name is spelled with two E's. She's so important. I got just one E.
She was important that night, for sure.
All right. The question was, if somebody wanted to get involved in country music today, and you're still a young man, but you're old soul too. So you've dealt with the young, you've dealt with the old. What's your take on it these days?
If I had any advice to give to anybody doing anything, it don't matter if it's a music business. Let's just say business in general.
Yep.
Business is business, no matter what kind of business it is. It works the same. Because at the end of the day, you're selling something.
Mm-hmm.
No matter what you're doing, you're selling something. And what we do, we sell ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have to buy the personality. They have to buy the person in order to buy the product. Because if they don't like you, they're not going to buy your product.
Mm-hmm. Agreed.
So you gave me advice that I keep with me all the time. Means more to me now than ever. And it's the same advice that I give people.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll give you your own advice. Surround yourself with good people.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And if it'll
work
do
every
that,
time,
then you'll know that you've got good things coming, and that those people are truly looking out for your best interest. Because when you can surround yourself with people that are looking out for your best interests, mm-hmm. because they like you, they love you, they care about you, then you can have your work family, and you can all be successful because you all want to see the other person do well.
I thought about what you said about Lori Morgan giving you advice. Mm-hmm. You know, you gave her as a reference. She said, well, let me reference you. And that's exactly what you're saying right now. You've surrounded yourself with people you can go to and get an honest opinion, not something you just want to hear. That makes
sense. You're
right.
You're right. And sometimes it hurts to hear stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes it hurts to know that, and it's okay. That it's okay to be wrong.
Mm-hmm.
And it's okay. Nothing feels better to me now than saying, okay, I was wrong. I
messed
wrong.
Up.
Yeah. And you know what else feels good to say? No.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Not being a yes guy all
yeah,
the time.
Yeah, I'm with you.
And obligating yourself to everything just mm-hmm. because you think you're supposed to, and you think you're going to hurt somebody's feelings, or it's okay to say no. Because, if I can say no to my kids,
mm-hmm.
why can't I say no to you?
Mm-hmm. Let's go back to music. If somebody's out there, just music, the way the industry is now, to me, and I know nothing about it, but to me, what I see of it now, I'd hate to know I was a young person trying to get in. Or is it different? Because now a young person knows has all these tools. You can't pitch a song anymore. They don't even know what pitch a song means.
Well, and it's a lot different now because, longevity and career longevity is very important right now. Because the old guys, think of the old guys now. Who are the old guys? Jason Aldean, Luke Bryan, they're the
yeah,
old guys.
You're right.
I mean, a lot of people, in your head, you think, well, I mean, that's still contemporary country music. And although it is, guys that are still putting out contemporary radio hits, they're the old guys. Blake Shelton, he's the old guy.
Kenny Chesney.
Chesney, he's the old guy. Somebody asked a question the other day. If you had to be stranded on an island with any celebrity, who would it be? And I think it was a country music celebrity. And I said Chesney because mm-hmm. I think he would know how to survive.
Mm-hmm. I
couldn't say Buffett because
I think if you're wanting to get in the music industry, that's fine and good. But have a backup plan.
About the industry. You said the music industry. If you're going to be in the industry, be open-minded to being in the industry, whether it be an artist, a songwriter, mm-hmm. a producer. Someone that's really good with marketing, social media management, mm-hmm. things mm-hmm. like that, to where you can not only help yourself but help other artists, and you'll find a job in the industry if that's what you want to do. It may not be the job that you set out to have, but sometimes the supervisor has to start out on the assembly line.
But can a songwriter make a living these days? A real good songwriter make a living these days?
Yeah, you can. If as long as you're networking like you should, and you're getting in those circles of songwriters, those 3, 4, 5 okay. songwriters, like guys like Luke Combs. I mean, he's writing a lot of his mm-hmm. stuff. Mm-hmm. So it being the whole package is another thing that people look at. Being a songwriter in Nashville is not the days of yesteryear where you could be a Dean Dillon.
Mm-hmm.
Those days are mostly over with. Because
how about gospel music?
Mm-mm.
Is that a different? Is that a different type?
No, because industry? There's still politics in gospel music. It's the same way.
Yeah,
it doesn't matter which genre you're in. Yeah. You're still in the music industry, and it all works the same.
To me, when you talk about music, to me, bluegrass music. That's just they're not in it for the money. I say most of them. They're just in it because of the love of music.
They do love the music. Yes, they do.
And there's
folks that make a good living playing bluegrass mm-hmm. music. And,
but they're not that many.
You got your cats that you think of. Very few household names that play bluegrass.
Yeah.
You got your a lot of folks know Ralph Stanley and Bill Monroe and, you know, them old guys, but everybody knows Allison Krauss. And, you know, a lot of folks know Ricky Skaggs. I'll even throw Marty Stewart in. He's a grasser in a sense. Emily Lou.
Birmingham Girl.
Those, you know, harmonies, bringing them harmonies to the table. And then Rhonda Vincent, you know, she's one of those ladies that's
Sweet
made
bluegrass.
A very good living playing bluegrass music.
And but there again, it's just that little old handful.
It's just a few of them. And
it's just like in playing baseball, football, basketball.
And you got to look, being in the right place at the right time is important.
Yep,
but, and I'll tell you this, you can be at the right place at the right time, but have you studied enough of what to do and how to take advantage of it when the time and the opportunity meet? Because that's really big.
What's Kevin Moon going to do for the next 10 years?
Raise youngins. Try to figure out how to pay for cars and college and all that stuff. If you could be stranded on an island with one country music artist, who would it be? Other than myself.
Willie, because I know he won't be on that long. I'm just joking, Willie. I love you. Turning 91 next month. We'll be right back. Cloud Nine, let me tell you something about this girl right here, Amanda Sullivan. She loves what she does. She's been there for 6 years. You've heard me say that before. Now she's thinking about Easter for mom and daughter. There's your two dresses. In fact, I was in there just the other day. I saw these, and I'm thinking, you know what? I just absolutely love them. You're going to love her and the rest of the girls at Cloud Nine, Main Street, downtown Ellic City.
At Beyond Home Care, we provide in-home care services to individuals needing assistance with activities in their daily lives. We work with each client to provide personalized home care and sitter services, whether it's assistance with bathing and personal care or an escort to a doctor's appointment. Each client receives the individual care they need with the dignity and respect they deserve. Give us a call today at 256-414-6090 or visit us online at beyondhomecareal.com.
The Morris Haynes Law Firm focuses on representing those who have been injured or mistreated by the wrongful acts of others. We have offices in Ellic City and Birmingham, but we have been calling Ellic City home for over 30 years. If you find yourself in need of a lawyer, give us a call at Morris Haynes, 256-329-2000. We would be honored to help you.
Lake Martin Mini Mall is geared up for spring with new inventory arriving daily. See our huge selection of big green eggs and accessories, along with our expanded lines of high-density daybreak outdoor furniture and complete solar lighting kits for home, patio, decks, and docks. Lake Martin Mini Mall is also excited to announce our local farmers and artisan market starting March 23rd, offering farm-fresh vegetables and foods. Shop Tuesday through Saturday and mark March 23rd on your calendar for our spring kickoff party.
Music Depot, located next to Depot Gun and Pond on Highway 280 in Alexander City, is stocked and ready for you to visit. Huge inventory of quality named drums, amps by Galani and Fender, electric and acoustic guitars, pianos, fiddles, every accessory you need for yourself or band. Before you shop out of town, shop Music Depot on Highway 280 in Alexander City. Call 256-234-6767.
At C&T Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Ellic City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
Jesse Henderson, owner of Henderson Glass on Dable Road in Alexander City, says give them a call today for a price, 256-234-5464. They do auto, commercial, residential, showers, shower enclosures, mirrors, tabletops. It's all about glass. So I'm seeing clearly if you are. Again, that number to call is Henderson Glass, Dable Road, 256-234-5464.
Hello, this is Scotty Gordon at Cornerstone Insurance. Are you tired of paying too much for your home and auto insurance? If so, give us the opportunity to help you. At Cornerstone, we have three goals for all of our clients: asset protection, affordable pricing, and superior customer service. Come by and give us a call today to see what we can save you. 153 Alabama Street, 256-409-2299.
Come on back in here and join us if you don't mind. It's about 7:30 on a Monday morning. I want to go to Dable right now and talk about Larry Stevens. And Miss P, good morning to you. He posts a lot of old vehicles, I thought I'd share this. See, this is his first car that he learned to drive on was a 1955 Ford Victoria. He said, I think Mom and Dad purchased it at Callahan Ford. This was for Dean Motor, but it's where Callahan Ford, Mr. Jim Callahan, is where the Outlook is today. So that goes back a few years. And the second car was a 1964 Ford Falcon. And I think I've got those backwards. The first one, the Ford Falcon was his second purchase that we showed first. But this one came from Dean Motor Company that Mr. Wimbledon have it.
Not that one right there.
No, that right there is the Ford Victoria. I had them backwards.
You had me a little bit confused.
Yeah, me too. But old vehicles like that, they would the colors were different.
Them. I love them.
What was your first vehicle?
I had a
truck, probably.
It was a Ranger, Ford Ranger.
Ford Ranger. Mm. Red.
Maroon.
I don't know why that's so funny. It's just funny
to me. Is it funny to you? It was a straight shift. I hate to drive a
straight shift. Straight shift. That one was on the...
It wasn't on the call.
No, I couldn't say that.
No. But now I don't mind it. I don't mind it. I burn up a lot of clutches in Daddy's truck.
I love the straight shift.
But, you know, I learned to drive in old trucks. Like, mm-hmm. Daddy had a 51 Ford pickup, and driving, he lived on a dirt road
mm-hmm.
that circled, and I made him many a circle around that dirt road mm-hmm. just in that old truck. He'd just let me hop in and go drive.
Mm-hmm.
I'd spend about half a mile on the paved road, but you know, 13, 14 years old, just make the circle.
You brought a bunch of caps. I go ahead and pull those up. I don't know what they're, because that's a lot of caps to dig into.
I like caps.
Oh, me too.
And I know that you do too. Mm-hmm. So I brought some things, and I'm going to give you a cap before we leave today.
Okay.
I'm going to let you pick, but you can only pick one.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
So now I didn't have time to, you know, I've got a lot more than this, but I just grabbed a few. And we'll just start with caps, and we'll show them. So it looks like National Signing Day up here. He just put them
on. GMC truck. That's a good looking cap.
That's not a bad looking cap.
That's good looking. But that's a cap.
All these
are big
caps.
Cap. Goo goo cluster.
Yeah.
All right.
How about that one?
Okay.
And see, whatever it is, you can just hang it up back there somewhere.
Yeah.
You know, that's an American made, Nashville, Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
Goo goo cluster.
Is that where Goo Goo's are made in Nashville?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that.
You did too.
I told you I didn't.
There's a
Talon, Blackburn Talon.
Yep, good fishing cap.
Oh, okay, Talon. Okay, I'm with you. I'm with you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, spread them out.
Okay.
Okay. Look at that.
Carquest. These are mushy caps. Folgers. T.G. Shepherd.
Look at there.
T.G. Shepherd had a, that was his in the NASCAR world. He's another one that's still going strong.
You can't
as
get
as strong as he wants.
You can't get this one. But I'll show it to you.
Oh, boy. Dale Earnhardt. Wow.
Well, you but see, I sell caps, too.
Are you a big Dale Earnhardt fan? Were you?
Yeah, I love that. To me, Dale Earnhardt was. Now, I was not a Dale Earnhardt fan as far as going out and buying a bunch of Earnhardt stuff. Mm-hmm. I really liked. I liked Davey Allison as a kid, so mm-hmm. I just kind of followed that 28 and 88. Mm-hmm. I was a Dale Jarrett mm-hmm. fan, and there's a pretty cool
NCAA
cap there.
Championship.
Yeah. There's a good looking deer cap.
Sure is, John Deere. Nothing runs like a deer.
Let me take the price tag off this.
This is cap signing day, I guess. Yeah. You mentioned signing day.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm going to let you pick a cap live on TV, whichever one you want.
A real good cap these days is a Richardson
brand. It's a good cap, yeah.
That's a real, in fact, one I have on is a
Richardson. That's a Richardson 112.
Yeah. 112, I didn't know the number on it.
Mm-hmm. Look at there. Medford, Oregon, Peterbilt.
Medford, Oregon. I'm not sure what my brother Charles just retired.
He said he just hit 8 million miles and then retired.
Yep. But I don't know what he was driving last.
I bet it might have had a Caterpillar engine.
Diesel power. Boy, you don't see the whole.
I tell you one you really don't see.
We got to get another picture of this, Ryan.
Look at there.
TNN Motorsports. Wow. The Nashville Network.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Raise hell, praise Dale.
Good wrench. Winston Cup champion, 1987.
This is a piece of fudge or something in here. That's a steakhouse out in Western, out
Western
in Texas.
Steer. Will they?
There's another Earnhardt cap.
Number 15.
Yeah, that was a Ford, I think.
I don't remember him driving a 15. Well, he made the number 3 popular, didn't he? Die Hard.
Signed by Gene Stallings.
Gene Stallings. Coach Gene Stallings.
Yeah. This is throwback.
All right.
You ready?
Mm-hmm. Quincy's Steakhouse.
Yeah.
Golly.
Them rolls?
Yeah, yeah.
Remember them rolls?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They had good rolls.
I'm going to just go ahead and say we've never had this many Shoney's. Is there any Shoney's anywhere around?
Yeah, I still stop at the one in Clanton.
Really?
On a regular, pretty regular basis.
Does it have the big boy in front of it?
No, but it's got a hotel near, motel next to it.
Really? Oh, next to it, yeah. I know the one here used to have one. Ruger?
Ruger. Old Ruger
gun.
Cap. Uh-huh. I sell caps. That's what I have. That's my hobby, buying, selling, trading caps.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Is Ruger made in the U.S.?
That cap is.
Or is that a German?
I don't know. I don't know where Rugers are made.
Well, you got corduroy?
The last two are corduroy.
You don't see much of these.
I brought in a Pampers box, so that's all we had laying around the house.
I bet you got plenty of those.
I do. Oh, listen.
Well, you don't see a corduroy cap much anymore.
Crook trucks and trailers.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, I don't know what to say.
Well, I didn't give them all to you.
So if somebody wants to buy a cap, do you do
installment plan? No. No, just
upfront. If they want a
cash,
half dozen.
Yeah,
do that. Mm-hmm. Personalized caps, that's what I was
thinking. I can. But a lot of times what I like to do is I like to look at this one I got on.
Mm-hmm.
Louis L'Amour.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I like
Western.
Yeah, old cowboy rider. Mm-hmm. And, I like to get older caps, unique caps, like this TNN cap. Mm-hmm. You know, that cap is, it's clean.
Mm-hmm.
It's, it was part of somebody's cap collection. And I get them and then I take them and sell them.
Where?
Unique, good caps.
Do you go to trade shows?
That's actually something that I'm going to start doing next.
Caps?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yep, going to different events and just selling old caps. And because, people, it's old, it's vintage, it's, you know, something you can't get unless you find an old one that's been taken care of. And you know, just like that mallard duck cap right there, you know, somebody likes mallard ducks.
Yeah.
That, you know, if it's a hunter or something like that.
Are you a hunter? I never have known you to be a hunter.
We used to go coon hunting.
Mm-hmm. With dogs? Or is that
with
how,
dogs,
the way
yes.
you go?
Uh-huh.
Is that the only way you go coon hunting?
And beer.
Oh, yeah.
And then I enjoy going quail hunting.
Really?
Huh?
Are you a good shot?
I think so. But I was raised around guns.
Over and under, or do you do a 20 gauge?
Just
or?
A 20 gauge, okay. Something like that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that. But do you go with dogs using for quail?
For
hunting?
Quail, you use a dog.
Okay. I've just never. That's just one of those things I never got into.
You would enjoy. You would enjoy, I think, bird hunting more so than. I mean.
Tom Young, my buddy, he loves to go pheasant hunting.
You wouldn't like sitting there just being quiet.
No. But it's kind of like playing bingo. They don't like for you to sit there and be quiet playing bingo. And I can't go play bingo anymore because you got to be quiet.
Because they might call that number.
No, and
folks can't hear it things a lot of times.
They're real sensitive, though. And I'm not knocking you bingo players. I love you because I know that's.
If somebody brings, it's kind of like if you own your own bowling ball,
mm-hmm.
I'm not going to bowl with you. I'm not going to get beat like that.
Mm-hmm. Do you bowl?
No, not good. But if you don't bowl good either, then I'll go play with you.
I don't.
It's like golf. I'm not going to golf with anybody that's good.
But I'm going to disagree with you there, because if you go be a golfer,
I don't want to be a golfer.
I think to
I don't even want to be better.
Okay.
Don't try to make me better.
We go put a cap on this segment. We'll be right back. Mitchell House is located in downtown Dable, two streets over. I'm talking about a place that's been there since 1835. I'm talking about a place that you're trying to make have an event this year, and you don't know where to have it. Well, you just found it. Go to MitchellHouseEvents.com today for more information for later.
Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center provides optimum care for the whole person. Dr. Demo Popov specializes in the prevention and diagnosis of high blood pressure, kidney disease, diabetes, and acute and chronic conditions. Our weight loss clinic offers lipo shots and a guide to healthy weight loss. Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center, where lifestyle changes are made.
Benton Clearing and Grading is Cody and A.O.D. Benton, and they get your job in sight. Moving dirt is a clean job to them. Clearing a lot for your home or business is what they do, and they do it right. Call A.O.D. or Cody today at 256-397-2531 or 397-2532 for a quote today. I promise you, they'll do the job right. That's Benton Clearing and Grading.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
With numerous industrial sites across the area, first-class workforce development initiatives, and a business-friendly climate, Tallapoosa and Coosa counties have just what your company needs to be successful. To find out more, visit lakemartineda.com or call 256-215-4404 to speak to Executive Director Denise Walls. Let us make it work for you. Call 256-215-4404.
I'm used to living alone, taking care of myself, Mr. Independent. But every now and then, I need a little help. My kids aren't close, and I want to stay in my own home. As close as family is such a godsend. Caring professionals here to help me with all the little things. Taking care of the house and myself, keeping me looking sharp. Feeling sharp, too.
Learn more at asclosesfamily.com.
They really are as close as family.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
The food at Oscar's Cafe makes your mouth water. At Oscar's, enjoy great-tasting catfish, or maybe you're just in the mood for one of Oscar's fresh salads. Even kids know the place for a fine meal is Oscar's with a great kids menu. Oscar's also has great-tasting burgers full of backyard flavor. So come on out to Oscar's Cafe for great food and homegrown hospitality. We're located on Highway 49 South in Dadeville, just before the Blue Creek Bridge. And remember, it's all fun and games till there's only one cheese ball left.
Welcome back to the Front Porch. Glad to have y'all tuned in on this lovely Monday morning. Kevin Moon, I got KD in with me, Kenny Dean, and appreciate him joining me this morning here on the Front Porch. Need to say hello to some folks tuned in. David Law, good morning to you. Linda Burkhalter, good morning. Mr. Don Harris over in Talladega. Ginger, Wesley, Robinson tuned in. And Daveville this morning. And Lisa Woodruff was listening this morning on her way to work. And we appreciate all of you that are tuned in, whether it be on the television side of things, on YouTube, online, collegecountry.com, or what was that? Is that the right website?
Yeah, I'm not sure, but I think you do. That's something I don't do.
But the radio enough. Side of things, if those of you tuned in on 97.5, good morning to you.
I don't do that enough because I don't check like I should during the show or text and that type of thing. Every now and then I will, but I don't do a good enough job now. When I'm out and about, I still got my yellow pad and my Sharpie.
I keep a note. I don't take a Sharpie. I keep a pen with me, but I take it. Actually, you're the one that kind of implemented that, but I don't do what you do. I don't go throughout my day and write down things that I need to bring up on the show because I don't have a show.
That's just funny.
Is that funny to you?
It's not funny right now, though, is it? It's not funny to you.
Right now. Yeah. You're right. I do carry a yellow pad with me, and I that's my list. I make a list of things that need to be done.
Cubby just said hello, too.
Good morning, Steve. Cubby.
Steve, of course, Cubby, as show he does, the Gospel Heritage video. He loves gospel music.
I do, too. And, country music is a lot of fun. Love country music. But I love gospel music, too. I love quartet-style gospel music. I like bluegrass and blue, but the thing about, and it's more so in gospel and bluegrass, because to me, there very rarely is there any in between. You can either have really, really good gospel groups, or really bad. Mm-hmm. And same with bluegrass, you're either good or you're bad. And I have listened to some, and I understand that biblically, make a joyful noise.
Yeah.
But it don't say make a joyful racket.
This reminds me, speaking of a racket, when we were doing the Barnyard Jamboree, and I love doing that.
Three people singing the lead part.
Oh. But
calling it harmony.
Ryan always had to bring Ryan up, because most time when I'd have a person or persons, a band, we didn't have many bands, but I would interview them also. That was part of the 30-minute deal. Well, we had this group come in here, and they were loud, and it took them forever to set up and get the sound. And then they were absolutely terrible. And when they finished, I left. I left Ryan. They weren't even finished. And I don't think I've ever.
I like that. You can do a whole show and just talk to Ryan.
We've talked about that. But I just, with my heart, I could not sit down and say anything good to him. I said, so I just left. And Paul Ryan, and it took them forever to take down. But they didn't come back either.
You mean they didn't want to come back, or you just
didn't want them to come back?
Oh, okay.
Did not want. But
it was on a Saturday.
No, you took up a Saturday for that?
Right, a Saturday morning. I forgot about it.
You had to come in for that? Good night.
You talking about a trooper, but I enjoyed the Barnyard Jamboree.
I'll tell you this: if anybody can at least help somebody sound better, it's that one in there.
You're right, Sam.
I love old boy to death. I wouldn't walk through fire for him, but I would do a lot to help him.
You know, you talk about a band, and you talk about sound. Sound's everything. I know when I was with Madwin, we went through, most time we just set it up, and, you know, whatever you got. But to have a sound person, or, you know what, took me forever to get used to, and when I finally got used to it, I loved them, monitors.
Oh, yeah.
When you can hear
yourself
it's like
I compare it to driving. If you can't hear what you sound like, it's like not being able to see while you're driving.
Yeah, you're right.
You've got to be able to listen. And
that's some advice for somebody getting in a
It is. Band. When I was worried, find a good, don't ever make the sound guy mad.
Yeah.
Because he can make and break the whole situation.
You know what the late David Florian would do? And I always, I'm thinking, golly, what'd you just, somebody would be playing somewhere and it would be loud. Somebody come up and say,
Can you turn it down?
Will you turn that? He said, Yeah.
Reach over and
turn it up. He said, perfect.
Nailed it. Just like I like it.
Oh, he was notorious for that.
Great. I love it. You know, me, when somebody come up to me and, you know, when you play country music and you play traditional country mm-hmm. music and you got a fiddle and you got a steel mm-hmm. and you got folks that are capable of singing harmonies mm-hmm. and, you want to use that. And country music that I grew up listening to that influenced me more than anything was ballad country music.
Oh, yeah, me too.
And I love stories. Mm-hmm. I love songs about drinking and cheating and mm-hmm. lying and leaving and squalling and mm-hmm. tears in my beer and whiskey bent and all kind of, mm-hmm. you know, songs about, you know, life and living.
You've been through it now.
And matter of fact, I had a guy call me not too long ago and asked me if I wanted to write. And I said, I've tried to write with you 100 times, and you never want to write. Why now? He said, because you just now went through a divorce. You just now figured out how to write.
Yeah. Well, and you also, I think it changes your heart and soul, I would think.
But when people would come up to me and go, can you play something fast? I'd play the slowest song we could play. I love you till I die.
Are you playing much these days?
No, not really. Just because I haven't really wanted to.
Okay.
You know, turned down a lot of stuff, and then finally got to where I turned down enough where I guess I quit calling.
You know, I'm talking about being in the band. It was some of the most fun years of my life. I was very blessed and fortunate to be surrounded by real good musicians and playing the stuff I grew up on, just old classic, the rock.
And you're only as, look, and you better have some good musicians because you're only as good as your worst musician.
You're right. Mm-hmm. But it was great years, and I'm glad I did it. It was one of those things I'd always, I guess, kind of wanted to do.
Bucket list thing?
Well, not so much a bucket list.
You got an Elvis suit.
No. I've had some. I had a white one.
You had an Elvis suit?
Yeah. I had a, who made that for me? I'm talking about a real nice one with a cape and. It was polyester.
Polyester.
It was hot during the summertime, and it was cold
in the winter
during the wintertime.
Was it tight in all the right places?
No, it was just it was not a comfortable thing, but it looked good.
Did it?
It looked good. I had a black one, and I think I had a blue.
Did you like the Elvis movie?
You know what? It was okay.
I absolutely love it. Well, it has become one of my top 10 all-time favorite movies.
Really? I thought Tom Hanks played the heck out of probably what Colonel Tom really was, you know.
I thought it was as good as Walk the Line and Ray. I put it right up there with Coal Miner's Daughter.
Wow.
You know, those.
Really?
Yes.
I wouldn't. But you know, the thing about, in fact, I just saw a thing yesterday on Elvis. He bought a ranch one time. I don't even know where. I think it was somewhere around Memphis. And he had to have some trucks. He went out and bought like 37 trucks mm-hmm. because he owned a ranch.
Because he owned a ranch.
We'll be right back. We'll wrap this thing up.
Why not?
Watch Kerr Market is down on Dable Road. Won't be just another week so. I can tell you about their new lunch menu. Right now at lunchtime, you're going to love their sandwiches and soups. Homemade, fresh, right there at Watch Kerr Market Kitchen. Go by and see them today.
It's truck season at Glenn Smith Chevrolet in Opelika. Check out the powerful full-size and fully loaded Chevrolet Silverado LTZ. Discounted up to $11,000 off. Or the roomy midsize three-row SUV, the Chevy Traverse. Discounted up to $7,750 off. And the perfect size Chevy Equinox up to $7,750 off. No payments until summertime. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
Hello, my name is Charlie Kuykendall. I'm the Minister of Music and Senior Adults here at First Baptist Church in Dadeville, and I am so excited about the Easter season. On Easter Sunday morning, that's March 31st, at 8:15 and 11 o'clock, you have an opportunity to come and worship, celebrate the risen Savior with us. We are looking forward to a wonderful day of praise and worship to our risen Savior that day. Come and join us.
Carlisle Heating Air says it's tune-up time for your HVAC system. Having your unit tuned up increases energy efficiency and can reduce the wear and tear on your unit. Call Carlisle Heating Air Day at 256-234-0019 for a price. Serving the Lake Martin area, Alexander City, Dadeville, Jackson Gap, and Goodwater. Don't get hot, be cool. Call Carlisle Heating Air today at 256-234-0019. Don't get hot, be cool.
For those who missed Zaxby's Egg Rolls the first time, these hand-rolled bundles of deliciousness are back. Just in time to take a sweet and spicy dip. Yes, you heard that right. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's. Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce. But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Wintertime in the South is mild compared to other parts of the country, but we still tend to be less active and spend more time indoors. Show your heart some love this winter by getting it checked out at the UAB Heart and Vascular Clinic at Russell Medical. I'm Dr. Kevin Sublett, and our entire clinic is dedicated to keeping your heart healthy. We're right here in your own community and backed by the knowledge and expertise of UAB Medicine. Make an appointment today by calling 256-234-2644 or visit uabmedicine.org/heartrussell.
While in Dadeville, Alabama, get off the roundabout and stop in Payne's Furniture. Donald Payne says right now the selection of couches with end tables is unbelievable. Comfortable bedding, rustic bedding, area rug selection like he's never had. Beautiful dining tables, modern and rustic. Ask him about financing. Or if you want to call him at 256-825-7727. That's Payne's Furniture in downtown Dadeville.
Tapley Appliance is now Presley Appliance and Furniture. It's all the same friendly staff. And Mike and Trevor Presley not only offer the best in appliances, from Whirlpool, KitchenAid, and Maytag. But now we offer full lines of furniture from Ashley, as well as a great selection of outdoor furniture. Make sure to visit the Presley family at the all-new Presley Appliance and Furniture on Cherokee Road in Alex City. Same great service and appliances, now with a great selection of furniture for home and outdoor.
I'm gonna turn it over to him. Let him see what kind of damage he can do.
Welcome back to the porch, y'all. Glad to have you here on the front porch live on WAXC TV this morning in Kalijah Country, 97.5. Lucy McVeigh, good morning to you. I got a friend right up here on the hill at Hillaby Towers. Uh-huh. Miss April Buno.
Hey, April. Yeah,
she's tuned
I know April.
In this morning, and you talk about just good folks.
Yeah, you're right. That gal right there,
she is salt of the earth people, and all the way around, just a dear friend of mine. And everybody that tuned in this morning, thank y'all. I don't know if I'll ever get to be on anything ever again, so I hope to see y'all down the road somewhere. Are we leaving? Are we getting out of here?
Yeah.
Why's that clock so bad off?
What do you say?
Huh?
What do you say?
What do I say?
Bye.
Bye.